Hello friends, welcome to AI Flux. So today when I got up, I read some wild tweets and I had no clue really what was going on, but it had to do with Stable Diffusion XL and supposedly the entire model now being available in a way you could use. Was it leaked? Yes. And this happened faster than I think any of us thought it would, because initially when I saw this tweet, I figured, oh, okay, interesting. I guess Emad officially wanted to release this. Yeah, here, like, they don't mention the word leak anywhere. It just says Stable Diffusion XL 09 is available with two links to Hugging Face and a Colab notebook, and also saying you could run it locally. So I figured, oh yeah, of course, the weights must be available. And we knew from what Emad said in sort of his roundtable that in order to get weights before 1.0, you would have to be a researcher, you'd have to actually apply. Curiously, both of these pages on Hugging Face have now been fixed. Before, the first time I opened these, you could actually just dump whatever you wanted, all the files were available, but now you actually have to submit an application. And that's true both for the base model and the XL base model. And you can tell there were a lot of people who got lucky and downloaded the living you-know-what out of this right when it was released. The comments here were pretty funny because these are people who basically opened the page and then realized, huh, okay, I don't see the safe tensors weights. Which leads me to the next sort of factor of this, which is the confirmation that this was a leak. So basically this is someone who applied for the research permissions to use the weights, which as Emad said, the idea was to give researchers the ability to use this so they can get some feedback from professionals first. One of those people decided to be a little goofy and similar to Llama, I don't think this was planned, this is clearly not planned, just release them on the internet. And they're now available in a link somewhere, which I am not going to post on YouTube, but if you happen to dig in Reddit, I don't think it would be that hard to find. And yeah, this all emanates from a user called Mystery Guitarm, and they've done a lot of fine-tuning work on the Stable Diffusion subreddit before. You've probably seen them before. They're an engineer. And before we go too far into this, I do want to say their post here is very important. So if you want to mess around with this, generally speaking, you want to avoid doing this with those checkpoint files, or those .ckpt files, because those are pickled, which is kind of a weird way of compressing stuff in Python, and they're technically executable. So for those of you who don't know, you generally never want to click on an executable that's claiming some cool thing that you're trying to get to, because usually that's a very convenient way for people with bad intent to end up with funny things all over your computer, if you catch what I'm saying. So only use links that may be linked to the potentially available safe tensors format of the Stable Diffusion XL model. Now that said, what's cool is people are using this and the results are pretty incredible. So some people are saying, oh, I'll just wait for the real link. These are all links that are definitely not working. Right, it doesn't work in automatic 11.11 now. Obviously, there's some tweaks you have to do. The key here is having PyTorch 2.0 and no XFormers, which is kind of interesting. The other curious thing is the reason there are two models is because Stable Diffusion XL works in two pieces. So you need both models for it to work. And there will likely be good methods for getting this code working in a general sense. I've gotten it working, but I'm going to be careful sharing this because I'm not sure how YouTube is going to treat that. We'll put it up soon. But in the meantime, we're going to be a little careful here. Now, what's interesting is Comfy UI also works. So there are other non-automatic 11.11 UIs that work with this. The coolest thing I've found digging through this is that it looks like you can do animations with it. So similar to Pika and a few other models, animation just works out of the box, which is kind of cool. And what I think is cool is there are people who have tuned the FP16 Safe Tensors base. And it looks like even with a meager RTX 3060, within about 30 seconds you can render 1024 by 1024 pixel images right out the bat, which previously was not possible. Like clearly this is not a quantum leap, but it's a big step forward in terms of the performance of Stable Diffusion. And where previously you had to have a bunch of goofy steps, now it's a little bit easier. And so you guys know, I was just running this through the terminal. I wasn't actually using a UI. I've been curious to try Comfy UI, so I might actually look into this. And Yeah, so the key is, yeah, you need the base model and the refiner. Both models are necessary. They're not really used separately. But when you prompt this, which it is more complex to prompt, I should say. Technically, this is the research version of the model, so you can still disable the safe for work filter if you want. Whatever, if you're into that. This is what's going on here. There also, curiously, is a Google Colab that's available right now. But you do need an official access token, though, and you have to be approved on Hugging Face for the research weights. So this is not going to work necessarily if you do not have the access. Now, that said, technically with RunPod, you could put in the unofficial weights that may or may not exist. But there are some incredible images that have come out. This is coming from the artificial guy. And what's crazy is these are single shot. So these are coming straight out of Stable Diffusion XL. And I think these models are crazy. What is important to remember here is it's not exactly surprising that a model that just creates larger images out of the bat would have more detail. That said, the coherence is great. It's approaching a general set of capabilities that is very close to Midjourney. I will say it is harder to prompt in terms of just with bigger images, there's so much more availability for different details and different attributes. So obviously longer prompts generally will get you better results. That said, that's always been the case with Stable Diffusion when you've compared it to Midjourney. Midjourney is sort of the beginner version of getting incredible images out of like 5-word prompts. Yeah, so these are just absolutely crazy. And it's, I'm a little bit disappointed that someone leaked these so early, but obviously the community is going to benefit vastly from this, and hopefully 1.0 will be even better with the feedback they get. Let me see here. So there's some landscapes. There's some portraits. There's a rabbit playing poker. Here are some illustrations. So again, illustrations, you're not going to see as drastic an improvement. This looks pretty cool. This is a chain-smoking Santa outside of a cyberpunk bar. And a very happy goat. I'll leave it at that. Let's see here. Here's another cat. And the Stable Diffusion subreddit also has a lot of images. So this is also a single shot. So a 1080p. And the detail is nuts. Like, if you showed me this and told me it came from Midjourney, I would believe you. And I would believe you that this is someone who knew really how to use Midjourney. So, just a quick update. It's funny in a way that this happened so much earlier than I think anyone thought it would. It might be a bit of a setback in that we have to kind of wonder if even researchers will be trusted with beta models in the future. However, I think this wildly benefits the community. And let me know if you guys are running Stable Diffusion XL, you're generating cool images, let us know in the comments. So as always, we hope you learned something. If you like our content, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video.